And we begin with a KCRA 3 investigation. Our undercover cameras catch state fair ride operators talking and tapping away on their cell phones while they're on the job. And now changes may be on the way to make sure everyone at the state fair is safe.
KCRA 3's Danielle Lee tells us what happened when we showed that undercover video to people in charge.
While you toss, turn, and spin upside down, ride operators are supposed to be watching, making sure the ride functions as it should. But we visited the state fair on two different days last week, and each time caught employees looking down, tapping away, and talking on their cell phones. This operator on the Footloose appears to be texting and charging his phone on the ride. Another employee running the Wave Swinger looks down at his phone in his lap. And this man operating the Windsurfer, he chats away on his phone during the more than 4 minute long ride.
Well, it's clearly a distraction.
We showed the video to UC Davis professor Steve Luck. He's an expert on the causes of distraction.
The thing about talking on a cell phone is you can be looking right at something and not notice something really important about it because you're focusing on what you're saying.
We searched state and federal regulations and found no policy specific to cell phone use. The state only requires that ride operators are in the immediate vicinity of the ride, and they leave more specific safety regulations up to the independent companies who operate them.
Norb Bartosik is the CEO of Cal Expo, and he says the state fair also relies on the companies furnishing those rides to create safety policies.
Oh, it's their company. I can't tell them what to do. We have a contract with them that basically says they'll follow all safety rules and obligations and regulations.
This year, that company is Butler Amusement. And it turns out they do have a policy about cell phones.
Our policy is no cell phones. They know it.
Butler manager Lance Moyer says employees caught with phones are given a verbal warning the first time. The second time, their phone gets confiscated. And the third time, they get fired. But now Moyer is reconsidering that policy after seeing what we showed him.
Maybe, you know, we need to look at renewing our policies.
Seeing this, what kinds of changes do you think need to be made?
Right now, I think I need to have a meeting with all the operators and refresh everybody's memory and maybe go to total termination on the first offense.
And as for the state fair, CEO Norb Bartosik says he'll be using a private safety consultant to make sure these types of violations stop.
We'll deal with it, and we'll deal with it quickly.
In Sacramento, Danielle Lee, KCRA 3 reports.
And it's not just the state fair with that no phone policy. We checked with some permanent amusement parks about their cell phone policies. Both Six Flags Discovery Kingdom in Vallejo and Great America in Santa Clara say cell phone use by their ride operators is against company policy.